So today we shall be studying about emulsion polymerization and suspension polymerization. So the first point under emulsion polymerization is, so emulsion polymerization is a type of radical polymerization that usually starts with an emulsion incorporating water monomer and surfactant. The most common type of emulsion polymerization is an oil in water emulsion in which the droplets of monomer are emulsified in a continuous phase of water. So let's try to understand how this emulsion polymerization technique is carried out. So this is our reaction vessel. This is the reaction vessel. And this is the fluid, that is the dispersion medium. So this is the dispersion medium. Dispersion medium. Now what we do is, so we add the monomeric units. These are the monomeric units, the monomeric units. So we add the monomeric units, and after this the next step is controlling the temperature of this reaction vessel. This reaction vessel has a controlled temperature. Controlled temperature. Now next step is adding the surfactant. So this is how a surfactant molecule looks like. It has a hydrophilic head. This is the hydrophilic head. Hydrophilic head and a hydrophobic tail. This is known as the hydrophobic tail. So hydrophobic means water repellent, hydrophobic tail, and hydrophilic means water loving. So what happens is, when many of these molecules are together deposited in the dispersion medium, they form aggregates which are known as micelles. So let me write this down. When surfactants are deposited into a dispersion medium, they form aggregates. And these are also known as, they form aggregates which are also known as macromolecules, and the colloid formed is called macromolecular colloid. Now this system of aggregates formed is also known as a micelle. We will see what a micelle is in a short bit. So this was a surfactant molecule. Now when all of these surfactant molecules are together deposited in the dispersion medium, let's see what happens. So this was the dispersion medium, which was water. The dispersion medium was water. Now if I put the surfactant inside this vessel, what will happen is micelle formation will occur. The micelles will look somewhat like this. So when the surfactant dissolves in the dispersion medium, this is the aggregated molecule that they will form. This is the aggregated molecule. It is also known as a micelle. So this will be formed. Let me write this. It is known as a micelle. Now all the hydrophobic parts, the hydrophobic tails are on the inner side of the micelle, and all the hydrophilic parts are on the outside, because the hydrophilic parts will try to attach with the water molecules. These are the hydrophilic parts. Hydrophilic part. So now one thing we should remember, these monomeric units are also hydrophobic. These are organic compounds, and hence they are hydrophobic, organic compounds. And so what they will do is, they will try to attach with this hydrophobic tail, and hence they will try to move inside this micelle. So you can see that the monomeric units have moved inside the micelle. Next, what happens is, we add the radical initiators. We add the radical initiators. So first let me clean this board a little bit. So now we add these radical initiators. These radical initiators. And what happens is, these radical initiators being organic compounds will also move inside this micelle. These will move inside these micelles, and hence the polymerization reaction for emulsion polymerization occurs within the micelle. Let me write this down. Polymerization reaction for emulsion polymerization. For emulsion polymerization will occur inside the micelle. So inside the micelle, this polymerization reaction will take place, and it will look somewhat like this. So such polymeric chains will be formed within the micelle. This is the polymeric chain. Now if you want to know more about radical polymerization, I have made a separate video on that. Just take a look on it. So this is the polymeric chain which has been formed. Now the next step is how to clean this polymer. So in order to clean this polymer, that is to remove this micelle, we need to add a de-emulsifier. So on adding the de-emulsifier, this micelle will lose its stability. This micelle will lose its stability, and hence it will break apart. So after adding the de-emulsifier, the micelle which was formed gets destabilized, and no longer we have the aggregated molecule, and hence the polymeric chain which was formed inside the micelle is now free. So lot of such polymeric chains shall be obtained, and hence after de-emulsifying we get the clean polymer. So this was the explanation part for emulsion polymerization. Now let's move on to writing the points. So now we study suspension polymerization. For suspension polymerization, it is a heterogeneous radical polymerization process that uses mechanical agitation to mix a monomer or mixture of monomers in a liquid phase such as water, while the monomers polymerize forming spheres of polymers. Now let's try to understand this suspension polymerization. So for suspension polymerization, we have this agitator which rotates at a certain RPM. Now what we need to do is we need to put the initiator which initiates the reaction, and along with the monomer and the initiator we need the suspending agent. So these are the monomeric units. And after polymerization we will have something like this. So such type of rings type polymers will be formed, rings shaped polymeric units will be formed. The shape will depend on the RPM, that is the rotation per minute of the agitator. Or in simple words, the shape of these polymeric units or the characteristic features will depend lot on the speed of the agitator. So now let's move on to writing the points for suspension polymerization. So the second point says that emulsion polymerization results in an impure polymer, and hence purification of the polymeric units are needed to be done. We have seen that for emulsion polymerization, we needed a de-emulsifying agent in order to remove those micelles. Hence these accumulate in the polymeric chains as impurities, and hence they are to be purified before the polymer becomes commercially available. And next is for suspension polymerization. So the polymer obtained is more pure compared to the emulsion polymerization. For suspension polymerization, the polymer obtained for after suspension polymerization is more pure compared to the emulsion polymerization. Let's move on to the third point now. So the degree of polymerization is high for emulsion polymerization compared to the suspension polymerization. And for suspension polymerization, it is low degrees of polymerization compared to emulsion polymerization. So the fourth point. So for emulsion polymerization, the polymerization process occurs within the micelle. So the polymerization process occurs in the dispersion medium and depends upon the agitator speed for suspension polymerization. Let's move on to the fifth point. So emulsion polymerization produces polymers of high molecular weight. And for suspension polymerization, small amount of undesired low molecular weight polymer is also formed. So emulsion polymerization is used for large number of monomers like vinyl acetate, vinyl chloride, chloroprene, acrylamide, acrylates and methacrylates etc. And for suspension polymerization, it is used for producing 90% of all PVC products. So these were the differences between emulsion polymerization and suspension polymerization. Thank you. We'll be right back.